Hello everyone, here we talk about the simple interest on equivalent value. Money value changes with the time. $100 is $100 now, but it may be $120 next year. Since interest always plays the role to change the value of the money. When we try to compare the money,Please keep that in mind. If few different amounts of money appear at a different time, we cannot simply add them together. We have to change the value to the same time. If we want to put them together, we have to apply interest rate to bring the money value to the equivalent value on the same time.Which is called the focal date. Money flow usually has only two directions, flow in or flow out. We use this idea about equivalent value to build up equations to solve the problems. The concept about equivalent. See, if you have a debt to be paid $100 today, if you didn't pay, next year you may need to pay $120.For finishing this debt, $100 now equivalent to $120 next year. Or it is equivalent to $80 last year if you paid last year. So that's the meaning of equivalent. Example 1. Two amounts owing from the past were to be paid today. One debt was $620 from 1 year ago, and the other was $925 from 6 months ago. Determine the single payment today that would fully repay the debts. Assume simple interest at 12% per annum. Let's look at the situation. $620 debt supposed to be paid 1 year ago. $925debt supposed to be paid 6 months ago, but they were not paid, they're still there. Now we want to pay the debt together, how much we need to pay. So $620, we need to consider interest situation to see how much it worth is now. That would be the equivalent value S1.$925 6 months ago, it will worth more today. When the interest being added in, the equivalent value would be S2. So clearly, we are going to calculate two future value. S1, $600 with 1 year interest rate 12%, give us equivalent value $694.40. And another part, $925 with 6 months interest, give us $980.50. Put them together. If we want to finish this debt, single payment today would be $1,674.90. Example 2. You are owed payments of $400 due today, and $500 due in 5 months, and $618 due in 1 year. You have been approached to accept a single payment 9 months from now with interest at 12%. How much will the single payment be? Let's look at the structure. So we have $400 need to be paid today. $500 need to be paid in 5 months. And $618 need to be paid 1 year from now. They all hanging there haven't been paid yet. Now we try to make decision.Put them together, pay one single payment 9 months from now. That's the S, red S labeled on the screen. So that means we need to figure out for $400 after 9 months, how much it should be the equivalent value. For $500 after 4 months, how much it should be that equivalent. And for $618, 3 months earlier, how much the equivalent value should be. So the equivalent value for $400 on the focal day is S1. Equivalent value for $500 on the focal day is S2. And the equivalent value for $618 on the focal day is S3. So we need to calculate this three equivalent value. We can see that S1 is the future value, S2 is the future value, and S3 is the present value. When we look at the value change from left to right, you are moving from past to the future. When you look at the flow from right to left, you are moving from the future to past. Put the three amount together, the single payment would be $1,556. Example 3. Scheduled payments of $400 due now and $700 due in 5 months are to be settled by a payment of $500 in 3 months and a final payment in 8 months. Determine the amount of the final payment at 6% per annum. Use 8 months for now as the focal date. Let's look at the structure. $400 scheduled to be paid now. $700 scheduled to be paid 5 months from now. So these two red debt together is the old plan. So right now we're thinking to make alternative plan. We're going to pay $500 at 3 months from now and pay another final payment 8 months from now. That's what we labeled $500 and another one X, we don't know yet, as green ones. So the basic idea is two red ones, old plan, together being replaced by two green ones, new plan. So they should be equivalent. When we compare them, make it equivalent, they should be equivalent on the focal day. The question pointed it out 8 months from now as the focal day. So we got to switch all the value to the focal day. For $400, the equivalent value on the focal day is S1. That would be the future value. $700, the equivalent value on the focal day would be S2. For $500, the equivalent value on the focal day would be S3. For that unknown payment exactly on focal day that is labeled as X. So here, we would expect S1 and S2 together being replaced by S3 and X together. That's our equation. We calculate each part first. S1 and S2 are future value. S3 is future value as well. And then we put them together as what we mentioned earlier. X and S3 are the new plan. Replace S1 and S2, the old plan. So they are equal. From here, we put all the number we calculated. We can get what we're looking for. The final payment should be $614. Example 4. Jeremy had two equal outstanding loans. One from 63 days ago and one from 105 days ago. He repaid both loans today with the single amount of $3,700. If interest is 9% on the loans, what was the size of the equal amounts borrowed. Let's look at the structure. There was a loan 105 days ago, and there was another loan 63 days ago, and they are exactly same size, so we can label them as X. And now paid $3,700 to cover these two loans together. So that means 2x together should be equivalent to $3,700. When we try to set up this equation, we make sure we have to compare on the same focal day. So our focal day here is now. As what you see, we need to bring x 63 days ago to the future value as 1, equivalent value. And we need to do the same thing for another x 105 days ago, bring to the equivalent value on the focal day as 2. They both future value. We can finish this calculation. Not final answer, since we have a x, which is the loan size we do not know yet. So we can carry this x just to make it convenient for the future equation. The equivalent value already on focal day, so we can set up equation directly as 1 and as 2 together should be 3700. From here, we can solve x. Turn out this equal size loan, each one is $1,812.46. Example 5. Collection Developments was supposed to pay Majestic Florin $2,000 60 days ago and $1,800 in 30 days. Majestic Florin agreed to accept 3 equal payments due today, 60 days from today, and 120 days from today. Calculate the equal size payment at a 10% interest rate. Use today as a focal day. So here we should clearly understand the structure. Original debt or loan, $2,000 60 days ago, $1,800 in 13 days from now. So these two parts, original debt, and they are to be replaced by 3 equal payments. One today, second one 60 days after, and the third one 120 days from now. We do not know the size yet. That's what we're looking for. So we use x to be the amount of the equal payment. So let's look at how much it worth, the old debt, two together. So we have 2,000 60 days ago. How much it should be for now, today, future value? $2,032.88. For $1,800 in the future, 30 days from now, how much it should be today? That is the present value. So we finish the calculation, $1,785.33. And then we look at the new plan. We have 3 X's. One X happened today, we don't have to worry about that. And the second X, we need to move the value to today. We calculate present value. We carry the X here for now, just get the coefficient in front of x to make it convenient for later. Similarly, we can work out the third x. So first x, second x, third x, we have all this equivalent value done. Put them together, they should be equal to s1 plus s2. And then we solve this equation, get our answer. $1,293.43. This is the size for the equal payment. Example 6. A loan of $200 made at 8.5% interest rate is to be repaid in 4 equal payments due at the end of next 4 quarters respectively. So that means each quarter. Determine the size of the quarterly payments if the agreed focal date is the date of a loan. So that means when we borrow the money, use that day as the focal date. That means the beginning, $2,000. Again, let's use X to represent the size of the equal payment. So the value of the 4 equal payments X was the following amount on the focal day. We need to switch every single one. The first one, switch back 1 quarter. The second one, switch back 2 quarter. So you can see at the bottom, this is a 3/12, second one 6/12. We are calculating present value. The third one's 9/12, 3/4 back, how much it is equivalent to. And then the fourth X, exactly 1 year back, how much the equivalent value is. So we have them all together since they are the values on the focal day when the loan starts. So they should be equal to $2,000. We prepared for the convenience to solve this equation. Now we simply can put these coefficients together to have X solved. It turned out $526.29 should be the equal payment size. See you next time.